We are live.
Goondocks, motherfuckers. We are here again. What do we do now? What do we do now? I got text messages coming
text messages.
Because I ain't met a motherfucker who could do that yet.
That's right, man. You know what it is. It's your boy, JKG, checking in. Goondocks, what's happening?
Yeah, yeah. Phone line's already jumping. My phone is. Okay. On today's show, we got Boombox Poets in the building. We got Jamarcus NOE. It's about ready to stop through. But first and foremost, real quick, I want to give a shout out to our very first sponsor, my longtime ace, number one from day one, Jason Kessinger, a.k.a. KK. Got the Golf Oasis spot over in Jeffersonville, Indiana, 1610 Dutch Lane, Jeffersonville, Indiana, Golf Oasis. Got the top of the line, most pimp golf simulators on the market today. So if you're a golf head like he is, like I am, and you know, weather's about to change and shit, you want to keep your golf swing intact, check them out. We will have the links up on the site here in a minute. KK, we will have the fucking banner up next week too. We had a little bit of a technical difficulty. This is a trial and error type thing. So anyhow, moving on. We'll shout you out again at the end of the show. KG.
What up?
What was popping today? Anything good?
Let's see. I'm logging into the chat boys right now. Looks like we had a couple people was already on trying to chat with us too.
Oh, yeah?
Looks like I would imagine one of them is probably our buddy Amiri King.
Oh, yeah?
King has spoken, logged in, and said we wasn't on yet, and he logged back out. But, you know, shout out to Amiri if he wants to call into the show or get back on the chat lines with me. You know what it is. There he is. He says, good. Maybe the goon has something important to say.
Maybe the goon always has something important to say. Like my fucking Pontiacs made with real fucking tomahawks. And Native American motherfuckers with tribal tattoos. And outrun a fucking Chevy and a Ford any day of the week.
What's good, man? Goondocks.com. Call us in, man. 502-251-4440. So we had a little technical difficulty. We was going a little slow tonight. Somebody decided to unhook my mixing board in the studio and didn't put it back up. So.
Doc!
Amiri says, yeah, but no tornadoes. I fucking love this guy.
I'm glad one of us does.
My BMW is made out of Jew babies. Okay. Real live Jew babies.
Hey, I'm part Jew. I take offense to that. Okay? The bad part, anyway. So, okay, moving along, let's not talk about shit that don't really matter, people that are irrelevant. So, Crime Times. Crime Times was interesting this past couple weeks. I'm not going to bust anybody's head out, but some of you seem to be undercover. Junk bags.
Hey, get out of here. Come on, man. Like, we're going to talk about it. I don't give a fuck busting away.
Speak on it.
I'm going to see a whole lot of motherfuckers here. I know. I see a bitch I know on the front page. Y'all know her. I think she used to come around Union a little bit. And I think I ain't going to put her out there by name, man. Y'all go check it. It's on the last week's episode anyway. Yo, the one on the front of this shit today, though, I got a funny story.
I'm ready.
Random thought guy. Watch this. So, talking about the Crime Time shit. The one that I seen in the store a minute ago, and I didn't grab a copy of it, it's a bitch right on the front of it whose picture is like this big, and it says, convicted of having sex, knowingly having HIV. You dirty rotten bitch is prostituting yourself. It said prostitution, knowingly having HIV. Out there selling pussy, and you know you got AIDS. That's some of the nastiest shit you could ever imagine. And I'm going to tell you why this hits a little close to home. A lot of y'all know my good homeboy Bugsy is locked up doing a little time, man. And he sends me a picture and a link the other day, or a inmate number of a chick, and says, look, man, this chick has been writing me letters, man. Go on and see what she looks like. Sure enough, he said, see what her charge is. You know what her charge was? Prostitution, knowing she has HIV.
Dirty bitch.
Dirty bitches.
Well, all I know is that if some motherfucker did that shit to me, first of all, I ain't paying for pussy.
Never.
motherfucker.
Well, we all pay for it in some way, shape, or form.
Well,
but,
you know, that's right. You got to take them out on a date, a movie, fucking buy them drinks and shit, get them, you know, whatever, slip them a Mickey, Bill Cosby style, whatever you do. But the thing is, motherfuckers pay me for the dick, you feel me? Anybody out there that may have got dick down by Skoon, go ahead and call in and fucking just go ahead and preach on it. Nell, if you're listening, go ahead and call in. Tell them how big my motherfucking dick is.
Little bitty dick.
Right. Another thing, man, you know what? Fuck it. I wish a motherfucker would call in and talk some shit. Because y'all want these problems. Man, look. I'm just going to get off this real quick before I fucking just blow a gasket. I'm going to talk about gas prices. And I'm going to talk about badass drivers right quick. Why is it that you motherfuckers don't want to use your turn signals? Ever. You do know that your motherfucking hand is on the steering wheel. Your finger is literally like a half an inch from the motherfucking turn signal. What kind of lazy piece of shit can't use his fucking turn signal? Now, I get it. When you're in your neighborhood, you're pulling into your driveway or maybe your street, nobody's around, you don't use it. I get that shit. But when other people are around, you need to use that motherfucking turn signal. Otherwise, there could be some crazy motherfucker like me ready to pull up on you to stop, like, yank you out of that motherfucking car and beat you to a living death for not using that fucking turn signal.
Caller, you're on the line with the Goon Docs. Who's this? I guess gonna call me and hang up on me, though?
Yeah, that's why. So, I'm going to touch on gas prices real quick. Thornton's is crooked. Marathon is crooked. Motherfucking, who's the other one? Speedway can suck a dick. All y'all motherfuckers right now are I hope the Attorney General and the Governor comes down on you motherfuckers and shuts all you motherfuckers down. Right now, you need to go get your gas from the Hodges. Straight up. I'm telling y'all that right now. There was a gas station on fucking Bardstown Road and Hurstbourne that's run by the Hodges, right? I saw it the other day. The motherfucker was like 217 or some shit. I go over to motherfucking Dixie. No, sorry. Go down Bardstown Road a little bit further. There's two Thorntons, one on each side. One motherfucker is like 249 or some shit, and the other side was like 257. Where the fuck they do that at? You need to go to the Hodges and get your fucking gas. I don't know if it's because they got a direct pipeline to Saudi Arabia or what the fucking deal is, but over here in America, the American gas stations or whatever the fuck you want to call them are fucking us in the ass royally still with no lube and no kiss, and that's bullshit. So go get your gas from the Hodges, man. They're not bad people. Besides, after you get your gas, you can get your chicken bone, get high on meth if you want to. Shit, that ain't so bad. Fuck.
I see Drew's online when it's talking about gas. It's 206 or where he's at.
Where's that? Is that Drew from Baltimore?
Yeah, Baltimore's in the building.
Well,
Amiri, call the phone, man. Look, you can put your phone number on there. I don't call out on the phone. You got to call in, man. 251-4440. Eric Cole 502. Call it, fucker.
Ain't nobody calling you. Shit. Please. All right, what's another topic we had hitting this motherfucker? I got to get on my phone right quick. Motherfucker's trying to get me flustered. Shit, let's rock. Oh, Cahoots. 36-day suspension on their liquor license, Cahoots. Now, I could really give a shit. I know the people around Cahoots and the Bardstown Road area are just sick of, you know, the activity that comes with just the whole drinking and partying and shit. And I feel them. I get it. I saw the video of the big-ass fight Mula Maisie shot. Shout out to Mula Maisie. Shit went viral. It's all over the place now. I think fucking they're showing it out on the West Coast. But my personal opinion about Cahoots is it smells like a fucking toilet.
And an ashtray.
Yeah, and an ashtray. I mean, if you've ever been to, like, an outdoor concert and it's, like, super fucking balls hot, and then you go into a porta potty that has just fucking shit in there from like, 10 o'clock in the morning. Let's say you go in at, like, 5 o'clock in the afternoon, 6 o'clock, when it's, like, the sun is beating right down on your motherfucking ass. That's what Cahoots smells like. As soon as I walk in that motherfucker, you got to walk past the bathroom, and it already smells like piss and shit as soon as you walk in that motherfucking place. And I don't know why anybody would want to frequent that place at all. So I don't know if it's just because Phoenix Hill got shut down or what. But
Nah, you know why? Because they got the one little junkie dude behind the bar that, like, nods out while he's pouring your drinks. I think his mom or dad or somebody said they owns the place. I went in there one time, man. Like, I've only been in there, like, once or twice, man. Me and my homie C-Dot went in there one time, and it was, like, dollar wells or some shit, and they're pouring them in glasses, like, this tall. And dude was so fucked up, like, while he was pouring a drink, he would nod out.
Oh, I can believe that.
Dude, we spent like $13, ate chicken wings, and walked out of there like holding each other up. We were so fucked up. That's why people go to Coles.
Well, yeah, cheap drinks and motherfuckers just are poor happy over there. But there you go. That's why you're going to get shut the fuck down. And I'm not going to lose any sleep over it. Matter of fact, I've had a couple friends that have had encounters with their fucking bullshit security over there and start, you know, trying to beat up on them and whatnot. Let me tell you something. I've done fucking security in one club or another, one event or another since 2006. If it's one thing that I don't do is jump on a motherfucker when it's unnecessary. Another thing I don't tolerate are motherfuckers on my team that beat on motherfuckers for no reason. That bullying and punk shit, that is not how you do security work. Security work is making sure that the fucking patrons are in there partying safely. Nobody falls down, cracks their fucking head, or no shit like that. Just because an altercation breaks out doesn't give you the fucking go-ahead to go ahead and start brawling. That's why I don't fuck with Phoenix Hill and those idiots over there. I had a guy that, you know, wanted to come on, you know, shout out to Keone when we went up to Cincinnati to do the MLB All-Star Party. I put out the feelers for some security, and I'm pretty sure that in the fucking post, I may not have, but... You know, when the dude told me that his prior experience was Phoenix Hill Tavern, I was like, swipe left. I can't do it. I know the mentality, and no, that's just not how we roll. So, moving along, we got Boombox Poets in the building. We're about to bring them up so they can get in on this action, live action. Maybe we can get some call-ins instead of being requested to call out. Because you don't want me to call out. Trust me. I know shit.
He's still under talking shit.
I know
too.
Shit.
I see.
Oh, my God. I know some shit. And you know I know some shit, don't you? Yes, you do. Yes, you do. I seen the inbox message the other day, motherfucker.
Rucker on the radio in the building. What's good, Ruck?
Shit. We're going to bring Boombox up right now, man. Come on up, guys.
That means you got to get your ass out of the chair. Right. He over huffing and puffing and
we
shit.
We got Josh French in the building. We got Mike Birch in the building. Boombox Poets, man. Y'all put your hands together.
Yo, you got a comfy couch, man. I didn't want
to
get up.
Right. We got comfy couches over here. What happened to our ovations? We need our sound effects.
He's still over here talking shit. Call the phone, Amir. Without all that old silly shit in the little chat room. Internet tough guy. I done gave you the number like three times. Call the phone. If y'all want to duke it out on the air, we can duke it out. Come on.
He don't want these problems.
Call the phone. I fuck with dude. I know y'all got y'all shit or whatever, man. I fuck with dude. He's hilarious. I still ain't forgot the first time the motherfucker prank called my radio show and told me he wanted to suck your cock live on the internet.
And that's the truth. I mean, I'm fully 100% proof positive that he probably will suck my cock. It's a fucking two-handed job, though, I tell you that.
That was good shit.
All right, anyway, off the dumb shit.
Yeah, see, the phone's working. I just wanted to prove a point. The phone's working. I'm calling from my phone right now. So 502-251-4440 for anybody that would like to call in.
And get served. You might be able to. So Boombox in the building. For those out there listening, watching, that don't know who Boombox is,
caller, you're on the line with the Goondocks. Who's this? And they hang up again.
Anyway, let's get back to business, man. I'm through with this fucking elementary school shit. We got Boombox in the building. For those that don't know about Boombox or who Boombox is, give us a brief little backstory real quick. How long you guys been rocking, where you come from, all that kind of shit.
Yeah, we hail from the South End. We've been doing this since about 1999. Long damn time.
South End.
South Side, that's right.
Answer that, motherfucker.
Get it?
I'm going to cut y'all, friends. We can answer this phone call one time.
It's all gravy.
Collie, you on the line? Come on, man. Stop calling and hanging up. That shit's petty as hell.
Quit getting my hopes up.
Give him a second.
We're going to get right back to you, friends. Hang on. Answer that phone. Caller, you're on the line. Caller, you're on the line. The phone works. I'm talking to myself. Y'all hear me? Talking to myself.
Hello.
Hang that shit up. Bye-bye.
So the phone works. We know that. So, yeah. Calling, hanging up. Keep playing on the phone, motherfucker. Frankfort and Nicholasville ain't big enough. You feel me? I done told you once I make your front yard look like Compton in a heartbeat. Anyway, moving along. My motherfucking blood pressure up. Shit. I'm on 7th and Hill, motherfucker. Come and see me. Come and see me face to face. How about that? You don't want it on the net. You don't want it face to face on the street. And you motherfucking don't want it in purgatory. Any of those spots. You don't want these problems. You think you can handle the goon? You can't. You're going to say some funny shit. I'm going to say some funny shit. But you're going to get served the fuck up. Believe that. So grow some balls. Quit hanging the fuck up. Call the fucking number. And let's fucking do. Bitch. Anyway.
French, what's good, man? Boombox is in the motherfucking building. I'm not entertaining this shit no more. I was just entertaining for a minute. But yeah, I'm not entertaining it no more.
Yeah, some old awkward shit.
Situation is awkward. Situation
about
is awkward.
What's going on? Shit.
Anyway.
I love everybody. I'll bring some popcorn next time.
Okay, so you guys have been rocking since 1999, man. It's a long-ass time.
That's correct, long time.
I can identify with that because I'm old as fuck,
so
too.
So if you haven't heard of us, you haven't been listening close enough, for real.
Right. I've been hearing about Boombox for a while. I've just been back in this whole, like, scene for the past, like, 3 years and stuff. So I'm still kind of getting familiar with a lot of stuff that you guys done.
French has to go back a little bit further. He has to go back just a little further because back in 99, we were called Institution.
We were Institution for about a little more than a decade. We dropped probably 2 full-length albums, shitload of fucking demos. And, you know, Boombox Poets formed around 2010, 11?
No,
2000? Yeah. 2000, something like that.
Whatever.
It's a time warp. It is a time warp.
Mike and Josh doing music together regardless of the name band.
Right.
For a long fucking time.
But Boombox been around since, we'll say 2010, just for the sake of fucking argument.
Okay. So since the inception of Boombox, what are some of the biggest acts, shows that you've done, opened up for, you know, that, again, for people that may not know who Boombox is?
Man, we opened for fucking Bone a few weeks ago. That was fucking insane. We opened for Ritz. There's all kinds of groups we're opening for. Shit.
Head P.
Ritz. Head P is a good. We frequent.
Bubba Sparks.
Yeah.
It's that Bubba Chatter.
It's good
times. Yeah, we frequent national acts. We open for quite a few that come through town. You know.
Bone's cool.
Bone was very cool.
I wasn't feeling too good that day, so I had to skip out on that show.
That show was live. Show was fucking
Collie, late. You on the line?
Y'all, what's wrong with America?
What's up, Giggles? Look, and then he hangs up again talking about it's my phone. My phone is working fast.
What was wrong with America?
Plus, he blocked his number. He didn't put his number on the webpage, though.
What a pussy.
You're a jerk.
A fucking pussy.
You see, look, my hands was right here the whole time. Ain't nobody hanging the phone up on you, man. He's a jerk.
Who calls and hangs
I
up?
I see Ruck's on the line with us, man. Ruck, what's good? I'll let me.
Ruck's probably over there laughing his motherfucking ass off.
He needs some drama. He wants to be entertained. Shout out to my homeboy Ruck on the radio, man. 98.9 in the building. You know what it is.
Okay. So, we got Bone y'all opened up for. What? Y'all got any new music out right now?
We're working on our third album right now. Writer's Block Volume 3 should be out around springtime. It'll be our third full-length album as Boombox Poets. So, we'll be checking for that. We'll probably drop some videos soon. You know, that's going to be dope.
Turn the volume down in the background.
Caller, you are on the line with the goon.
You're not NWA, bitch, for real. G-A-Y.
Motherfucker, you are. Look at you hanging up. Why you hanging up like a hoe? You H-O-E, hoe. You ain't
NWA. I ain't entertaining
no
more. You know my phone number. You call my phone directly. I ain't entertaining
no more. He don't want them problems. Everybody out there that's going to see this shit know that he don't want them problems. I'm G-A-Y in N-W-A, motherfucker. I know I'm not N-W-A, motherfucker. I am Scooby.
Hello, we're white.
Right.
Hello.
What kind of shit is that? I'm not N-W-A.
White guy.
And you know what? You're not, motherfucker. You're not talented. You're a one-trick pony. See, the thing about it is, I can do what you do, but you can't do what I do. Understand that. By completely surrendering to the natural world. I surrender to nobody. That's it. We got with this growing pains right now. We got to deal with that shit. These little pop-up ads. We're going to take care of that, though, because the show is building up steam, especially when we got faggots like a Mary King tuning in. I already know I'm on the radar, motherfucker. Shit.
It is what it is, man. So what's coming up next for the Boombox Poets? I think I know a little bit about something, but I'm gonna let Birch slide his ass in there and grab the microphone.
Break the studio down here. Yeah, screw up a little bit, Scoon. Thank you, brother.
So that was when you put one skinny guy in a room with three fat people.
Pull this little seat over like
who you calling fat?
Your mammy.
I got a fat cock.
A little bitty
married
dick.
Married life, it will do that to you, man. It'll make you get them real home-cooked meals. You know, man. Let me get up in here.
Shout out my girl, Liberty Bell. She's in the chat room with me right now. When I say white guy, she says she sounds whiter than both of us.
No.
I love her. That's my buddy. Mike, what's good, man? What we got coming up next?
Well, we got some shit going on, man. We got a couple shows coming up in the near future, man. November 21st, we got our Gobble Wobble, man. Trixie's putting it on. Trey's doing a lot for our scene, trying to get shows going and whatnot, and it's important that he's doing that for real because it's a case where a lot of venues, man, you don't really get a chance to make your money back on some shows, so it's important to really promote this and do the damn thing and get out there and work because it's tough. It's tough for artists. But anyway, we can go on about that for days.
Let's touch on that for a minute, though. I kind of like that idea. What's some advice to some guys that have been around as long as you guys have and as long as I have? We got a lot of artists that tune into our show and support us. As far as paying to get on a show, what's your feeling about that?
Well, I've got strong feelings about it. I usually bite my tongue on stuff like this just because people...
Fuck that shit. We're on the internet. It's uncensored. Don't bite your tongue.
Yeah. And it's a case where... I don't know. It after time, doing shows in the beginning whenever you're doing your music, it's important to, go out. And there's things that people really don't talk about anymore. It's called paying dues. And there's certain things you got to do with these shows, man.
Go ahead. I'm not going to interrupt you. I'm not going to interrupt your speech here.
If we answer the phone, you need to be on the phone. But anyway, like I was saying, you go out there and you do your shows. You're paying your dues in time, You might not get the best shows. You might play first. You might get a bad deal. But in time, it'll pay off, and it'll be a lot better for you. There's going to be opportunities available. Once you market your product to the fullest, the sky's the limit. It really gets to a point where you can plateau here in this town, especially in our dome we call Louisville because it's difficult as any city, you can plateau at a certain point where all you'll have left to do is going to be make good investments and bad investments. And that's really on the track that we're on right now is the only thing we're trying to do is make good investments and stay away from the bad investments. And even if it is paying to get on a show, regardless, if you're going to make your money back or you're going to make some money or you're going to break even, and don't think when we booked that Bone Show, we wasn't sweating bullets on that $900. We were. It's important to know. That makes you a good artist to know that you have to thrive to know you ain't coming out of pocket on them shows. It's important. So like I said, whenever you get to that point where you need to make good investments and bad investments, you really got to do the right thing. And you got to follow through with it. It's important, dude. I'm very passionate about the fact that we're at that point now with Boombox. It's not just, hey, let me get them on a show one Friday night with a roster of 20 people. We're doing high-end shows, and that's it. So it's important to go to that plateau, really.
That's what's up. And, you guys do a really good job at it. And like I said, just, try to give some of these artists some knowledge as you're doing, man. Your merchandise has got to be right, too. Don't go pay to get on these shows just because it's going to be fat and then show up with no CDs and no T-shirts and no stickers, nothing from anybody to remember you back. Because I'm going to tell you, somebody come to see Bone, they came to see Bone. They might have liked you, they might have vibed with you, but, they're not going to, go home and, try to find you if you don't give anything. And I've done probably 50, major act shows in the last 10 years. As a, performing artist, manager, DJ, host, all that. And you got to make sure that you're branding yourself properly. And I know you guys with the CDs and the T-shirts, y'all do a great job at that.
And it's important.
I'm sorry, Frolic, just being just a second. It's important to take that merchandise with you because you might get stuck in these shows where it's all about opportunity and there ain't no money to be made off what you did for a month. So, I mean, you want to try to scratch something or at least do something. Like at our last show, we really didn't have a lot of merch left. So, you know what we did? We just threw it all out in the crowd. Why not? Get the promotional on the new faces.
Yeah, I mean, at least they got something to remember you by other than, oh, yeah, I saw those guys at the Waka Flocka show or whatever. That song they did was hot, but, you know, they didn't go home and buy nothing off iTunes or no shit. Nah, you know what I mean?
Yep. Yeah,
it's
you're
just
right.
The way of the world these days.
Fuck 'em. Yeah. You want to add to that, Fry?
We pretty much covered that.
I mean, it's just important, man. Yeah. All right, go ahead and answer. Let's answer. Pick up the phone. You know, we love you. What's up?
Caller, you're on the line.
I remember King.
Hey.
King's
fucking. Oh, fucking dickhead.
You know we love you. Y'all might have some beefs, but Boombox got nothing below.
Nah, I love King, man. That's how y'all fuck with dude, man. Like I said, him and Scooty got they got their own bullshit. Man.
Y'all need to get in the octagon or something.
I love dude. Yeah, I wish they'd just fight, get it over with it. Let me stream it on the internet.
Bro,
but
I think that's what they ought to do with all beefs.
Yeah, I don't think King wants that. Scooty's kind of a big boy. I don't think King wants that action.
Hey.
Fuck my size, fear my skill, motherfucker.
You are trained, you know. You are trained. But I think all beef should go down like Celebrity Deathmatch. I remember that show on MTV.
That was the greatest shit ever.
All beef should go down.
I actually
booked that show.
I actually tried to do some things like that. Like, we was going to do like a boxing glove rap battle type deal with some people that was beefing. But, like,
man,
you can't get anybody to book that kind of shit because Kentucky, for some dumbass reason, really does have a boxing commission. I don't know why there's a boxing commission here in Kentucky, but you can't, like, do any shit like that. Like, you get shut down. You can do it in Indiana. That's how they used to do the tough guy fights and all that. The tough guy competitions, they were always in Indiana.
Take it to the edge of town.
Yeah. One thing I did want to touch on really quickly, man, just because we got to do that. It's a big show coming up, guys, at Trixie's. And, look, I don't want everybody to get the bad idea about Trixie's. Yeah, it's a strip club, whoop, whoop. It's been a strip club a long time. But Trey has done a lot. Kevin can speak for this as well. He's cleared all of the dancers and stuff out of that side room and made it a music complex.
The concert hall is nice. It's
nice.
Yeah, I mean,
for
what they're using it for, it's great. I mean, I said the same thing to Trey, and you and I talked about this. It's people, they can't get away from that branding of the strip club.
It's a stigma. It's a stigma.
You know,
if
it was my place, he should have changed the name to the other side of it or something.
Maybe,
you know,
like, yeah.
Because people know Trixie's has been a strip club for how many hundreds of years? I mean, that motherfuckers had dinosaurs stripping in there. You know what I mean? Like, so I think that's, you know, that's the only thing that's hurting him. The sound system is great. I was just there with the dude from Rehab with Magic. We had a great time. The staff was cool. The venue was cool. You know, I mean, it was a great night, but I hope some more stuff goes up better.
It worked for Union. When you switched up to US Lounge, it perked it up a little bit.
It did. You know, and sometimes, you know, I'm a big, huge fan of John Taffert from Bar Rescue.
Damn,
I don't know if you guys watch it. It's like one of my favorite shows. I rewatch it and rewatch it because I'm in the nightclub business, so I stay on that shit. And branding is real important, man. It's, you know. I wish him the best, and, you know, I'm stoked to be over there with Yin Yang Twins. We're going to turn that motherfucker out.
Oh, yeah,
Yin Yang.
I got to talk about the show, too.
The Gobble Wobble is going down. KG and Mixed Magic is going to be in the building.
Yeah. Hey, Magic showed out. He really impressed Trey from the bar. He watched the whole fucking show. Girls were tipping him. It was love. He did exactly what he needed to do to get on that show, man.
I forgot about that. It was chicks in there putting dollars in Magic's pants. I forgot when his wife stopped watching this. I'm sorry.
And you go in the strip club and you get tips in your pants, that's royal pimp shit. I have to say so.
Yeah,
I have to say so. But like I said, I want to go through all the artists real quick, and I'll let y'all get to y'all's thing, man. I really appreciate it.
Hang on a
second.
Ads running in the background, all right. So just keep talking shit.
I know you want to. We are disclaiming all fighting from you and Emery because we are cool peoples. I don't give a fuck. I love both y'all.
I just picturing Scooney and Mary King like claymation.
Celebrity Deathmatch.
Fighting in the back of a Chevy pickup truck.
it would draw a crowd. It would draw a fucking crowd. Hey, isn't it all about?
I'm all for that. Yeah. I had another segment that we were gonna do at one point, and I chose not to, but I had a segment we were going to do here out of the studio that was called Can't Whoop Me TV. We were going to like talk about people publicly and like critique music live. And I thought, yeah, that might just put an X because anybody that really knows me knows I'm a fucking prick. So, like, I could be a real asshole. And I'm like, yeah, as fun as that concept is, and as much as I would love to do it, it's probably not a great idea.
I think that's gold.
Yeah, it's gold. Yeah, it's gold. That's gold. I mean, you know, who wants to walk around and have to look over their shoulder all the time? Because I ain't going to filter nothing.
That's true.
And plus, I can fight. I don't give a fuck. I'll fight motherfuckers out here on the concrete and put it on the internet. I can give a shit less.
It would definitely be bad, I think, maybe. But yeah, it's
gobble
right.
Wobble.
Let me get this out, guys, just because it's important to support the venue and the artists, because Trey let me really have the reins on a lot of these artists, so it's important to get out and show that you love them. You know, we got David's going to be on there, Mixed Magic, definitely. We got Shine. He's definitely an awesome artist, doing a lot of stuff for the community. Shadow Pact out of the Grimy Rhyme Regime team, they've always been killing it.
Dope.
Mike D's with Defiance going to be there. A lot of these artists, I'm really glad they bought into it, and yes, they did. They made the investment to get on this show. And we made it at a point where they're going to make their money back. You know what I mean? It's not going to be, and my phone just motherfucking died on me. Are you shitting me sideways? I'll try to play this off top. There he goes. All right. I
had to slam it on the table one time. Yeah. You know,
just pick it up and drop it.
Drop it like it's hot.
Anyway, all right. We got Shadow Pack out of the Highlands groups and whatnot and Grimy Rhyme Regime. Great team. I've always followed them. Another team that's, I'm sure, disappointed Phoenix Hill's gone, because we got a lot of opportunities out of that place. If I could get my screen to fucking wake up.
If you quit slamming the goddamn phone on the counter, it might work.
Pick it up and drop it.
Can you bring up the flyer for me, man?
I'll see what I can do.
Right. I ain't even seen the flyer yet.
Derby City Music's on it, man. They jumped on. It's pretty cool that they're going to be in on it too as well, because I know that they are building up steam with their following as well.
Yeah, they got. I DJ for them, man. They got a nice little. They got a nice little fan base going, man. They're putting out some hot tracks. Shout out Austin P, man. That's my homie.
Let me drop this one a couple times, right?
Hey, don't drop mine.
I ain't going to drop it. Anyway, yeah, DMC's got it. Cam Dollars, I'm not sure if you guys have heard him. I'm sure. I don't know if you've worked with
him. Cam is a monster. Yeah. He is one of my favorite artists from the whole state of Kentucky. Like, I love Cam. He's wild as hell.
Yeah, we're on it. And an electronic dance DJ named Gizum, he's really good. Cody's awesome at what he does. He's going to come out and enjoy the show with us. But tickets are $20, and you can get them online now. They're going to have, what's Trey going on here? The Crunk Cup Contest. Winner gets your cup filled all night long.
Woo!
So I
sounds
guess
like my kind of party.
Yeah.
Nice cup, I guess. So, whatever it is, it's November 21st. You guys need to come and do the damn thing and party with us. It's going to be fun. Shout out to you guys for letting us run Message last week, dude. It was awesome. A lot of people loved it. It was a lot of people were like, wow, Mike, that's awesome. I'm like, yeah. It sucks because I only think about the moment after, man. Anytime we do something big, I'm always thinking about the moment after, because it's just going to be, you're back to normal.
Yep. Right.
You're just back to normal. So whatever you do in life with music, that's the advice I need to give you. Whatever you do in life with music, the next day, it's all going to be back to normal.
You know, that's right.
And that's all I got.
That's what's up, man. We appreciate y'all coming in and rocking with us, man. Boombox in the building.
You. Fry, you want to sit up and yap with him about some shit you can?
Yeah, we ain't going to do nothing but talk shit. You're more than welcome to sit up and talk shit with us. Jamarcus is supposed to be coming through at some point and fucking with us tonight, too.
No promo ass told the mic and shit. My bad. But, you know, I'm just trying. Gobble wobble November 21st. Kev's going to be here. We're going to do a damn thing.
We're going to get it in, man.
Yin Yang Twins.
Yo,
did I even say the Yin Yang Twins?
Yeah, actually, let's go back to that. The Gobble Wobble
Yin
is
Yang Twins.
The Yin Yang Twins.
Whistle while you. I don't give a fuck.
She got her hands along the knees and then her bows on the thighs. Yo, I want to address whoever a non-333 is real quick. First of all, I'm not shook. My mind was elsewhere. I was texting my sister in California, who's texting me, wanting to know who the faggot was calling in and hanging up. Well, she now knows. And she's like, "What is he, a terrorist? What kind of name is that?" I said, "Well, you know, well, YouTube him, you know, a lot of other people do." So, shout out to YouTube for making retarded people famous.
let me get on one more thing. I forgot to say something about this. Fry, you can tell more about it. October 10th, we're going to have an open jam session for Boombox. We want all guitar players, keyboardists, drummers, anybody and everybody. We're going to start having jam sessions. We're going to have a full live band. Fuck dumb shit. Fuck the dumb shit.
Where is that going to be? Where is that going to be?
That'll be at Mike's crib. Just hit Mike up on your social media site. See what's up. Open jam session, October 10th. Boombox Poets.
So, I'm going to jump in my phone real quick again, because I got topics that I got, you know, just noted. Sometimes I need to, you know, go back and look at them. You know what I'm saying? I've smoked a lot of pot in my day. So, sometimes my brain cells don't work too good. Oh, here's one we can talk about. David Cam on Facebook.
What?
Peanut butter and jealous?
All that time, dude, just be like, I'm cool. I'm just
look, I can't, you know, I wasn't there. I'm definitely not one to cast the first stone. I mean, the dude got convicted twice.
Somebody else wants to call in and talk about David Cam.
Let's see.
Caller, you're on the line with the Goondocks.
This motherfucker's calling me playing my song that he sucked my dick over for the longest time. Enjoy that, because I'll never send you another track again. You'll have to rip that shit off the internet like everybody else.
Kill yourself, egg.
Right. End call. This dude's got no balls, man, for real.
I don't know what to do with my hands.
You're not NWA.
Hey, she fuck killed that. She killed my joke though. I was getting ready to do it. That was, I don't know what to do with my
so
hands.
So anyway, back to David Cam. I have like 50 mutual friends with this motherfucker now, and I'm like, okay. Well, okay, he did get exonerated the third time around after he thoroughly broke Floyd County down with these trials. So, I mean, I don't know. Maybe there's a chance he isn't guilty, but
and OJ didn't do it.
Right. But I do know that I do personally know someone who had to go and testify against him at the first hearing in Floyd County. Unfortunately, she has passed away within the past few months due to a problem that seems to be plaguing a lot of us these days. And that is heroin. So, but regardless of that, she clued me in on a lot of shit because, like I said, she had to go and testify with a bunch of other women about his conduct as a police officer. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean he's a murderer just because he's a cheat and piece of shit. But, you know, something is afoot. And I just don't understand. You know, I mean, I guess, you know, you gotta let the dude live his life or whatever the fuck, but you gotta remember that there's two babies and a woman that are no longer around. And the fact that this motherfucker has the balls to put himself on Facebook and shit, and then people that are in my, you know, friends list and circle or whatever want to, you know, be friends with this motherfucker, I don't understand it. But again, I guess it's not for me to understand. But that's. Anybody got any ideas on that? Fucking call in as long as your name isn't Tony Shork.
502-251-4440.
Or Amiri or Amiri or whatever, however the fuck you pronounce that gay-ass fucking name. How did you come up with that bullshit anyway? Amiri King, and the king has spoken. Bitch, I'm going to tell you something. You come within eyeshot of me, I will slap whatever invisible crown you think you got on your motherfucking cocksucking head straight down the street. Motherfucker, I ain't NWA. You're goddamn right, motherfucker. I am GWA. Think about it.
All right, man. We ain't going to entertain that shit no more, man. No more.
Oh, come on.
Come on. Let's find another topic. I'll be like, fuck David Cam, too. I was over kind of snoring. Right. Let's fuck that dude.
Where's Jamarcus NOE at?
Yeah, Jamarcus was supposed to be coming through, but, he's running late.
He's like, fuck what you think about me, player, huh?
We had a last minute substitution. Mixed Magic was supposed to be with us tonight. Couldn't get off work. Shout out to everybody checking in for Boombox.
Fuck a job!
I see Boombox Sports is that hot fire, they say. That's what's up.
Hell yeah.
It's that hot. I spit hot fire.
I don't know who Boney B is, but shout out to Boney B listening at work, too.
Boney B, good for bringing. Hey, Boney B. Matter of fact, when you brought up
that was Boney from the dude from Guys Home. Yeah, my bad, Boney. What's good, man? Lexington in the building.
When you brought up Grimy Rhymer, no, not Boney L's. That's Boney B from Headliners.
Yeah, Boney B.
When you brought up Grimy Rhymer regime, shout out to my boy Steve Johnson, aka Poe. Yeah. I know he's going through some medical issues right now, man. Best wishes. I've known Poe forever. Me and this dude used to ride a school bus back in the day and shit.
In the 60s. Yeah, Scooney's old.
In the early 80s, shit. Some of you motherfuckers out there are like, I was born in 93.
90s babies.
I was getting head jobs in 93, motherfucker. What you mean? Shit, no, but shout out to them right quick, man. You know, wishing him a speedy recovery. Dude's sick on the mic, too. He's a monster. Nasarima, sick on the mic. Always been a monster. Chaotic. And Boney B, they used to run with a little group called Soul Factory. And Boney's killing on the mic, too. He wanted me to touch on Independent. Yeah, Independent. Yeah, yeah. He wanted me to touch on Kevin Gates. James, will you get the door, please?
The doorman.
James.
Alfred.
James.
Home, James.
You get the door, players. Who is this? Who is in the building? Fuck what you think about me. Yes,
what's
sir.
Good, NOE in the building. What's happening?
NOE in the building.
Hey, man, we know. You good.
You made it before. It was
some last-minute shit. I just booked him today. You know, it was some last-minute shit, so we appreciate you.
So, what was you talking about?
I know I was about ready to ask you what the fuck I was. Oh, Kevin Gates.
Yeah.
So, apparently, I guess Terry Harper is bringing Kevin Gates to Louisville, which, you know, business-wise, you know, it is what it is. I saw a comment, you know, some guy was like, fuck Kevin Gates and blah, 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 blah. And actually, my bad. It was Boney. He was like, why are you bringing this dude here? He's a piece of shit. And, you know, which I agree. You know, who fucks their cousin and fucking kicks fans in the face and shit?
You
like,
see the picture he was doing with the people? He was like, I don't even want to
but
be here.
A business move, you know, like Terry commented back and he said, if I put my personal feelings in with this shit, then I wouldn't be booking anybody probably.
Yeah.
So I get that. Business-wise, it's a good move. I guess it's going to bring people out that like Kevin Gates. I personally can't tell you one of his fucking song titles.
I tried to check him out earlier.
I'm not a huge – yeah, goondocs.com.
But, you know, I'm not really into, like, the whole, like, trap music. Some of it's good and catchy and shit. The guys that do it around the Ville, I'm into for the most part because it's my home fucking city. You know what I'm saying? And they're doing. What's that? He said, I don't believe everybody in the city too. But some of the shit is catchy. You know what I'm saying? And I could see it, you know, doing, you know, running with the national recording acts being on the charts, all
going
that kind of shit.
Slim Jesus show, dog. Is that what you're saying?
I'm trying to get Slim Jesus on this motherfucker.
Trixie's got a bit on
Jamarcus,
Slim Jesus.
Jamarcus fucks
like,
with Slim Jesus. So,
I don't know, man.
Slim Jesus got a little bit of credit in the hood already.
Hey, man, I just see that shit. Hey. They brought him up as a special guest. And they brought him up with Chief Keef as a special guest in L.A. like last week. I seen everybody posting pictures and shit of it. I'm like, you can't hate the kid. Yeah, yo, he did a show with Chief Keef at the fucking, like, some arena and shit in L.A. Like, you can't hate on the kid.
Kev, did you
see
my post?
I think he's trash, personally.
I seen my post earlier.
Yeah, I said, you seen what I said? It'd be like, you know, if it's an all-ages show, it'd be like a whole bunch of 14-year-old Chief Keef fans in there. You know.
Trey got a bid on it, but I don't know, man. All the people in there that's commenting are artists, and they're like, no, artists.
Yeah,
no,
of course they
no,
are. I mean, dude
no,
is fucking,
man.
He just got like a million fucking hits on YouTube. Of course
either.
They're hating on him.
I mean
personally, I think
either,
the music's garbage, but you can't knock the kid is.
I will never knock anybody's
hustle.
It's
a business.
Yeah. If you're hustling
make,
your
I
shit.
I mean, it's their business. You know what I mean?
Can't knock the hustle, ever.
It's their business.
If you make money doing what you want to do, I can't ever, ever.
It's their business.
Right.
It's what they do.
Right. Amiri King. Amiri King.
I'm going to let Jamarcus get up here, but hey, love y'all. Stop bitching about Amiri, dog. It's all love.
No, he was actually going to say something nice.
Aren't you done with your interview? Why are you still up here?
It's all love.
Why is you still up here?
Because I love you, brother. All right, I'm out. Look, Gobble Wobble, November 21st. Come out.
Okay. Nah, but what I was saying is whether you're – you know, whatever my personal feelings may be about anybody, if you're doing what the fuck you want to do and you're getting paid for it, I can't knock the hustle. Now, I will call you a piece of shit human being, but I won't knock your fucking hustle. And I especially like the ones that like to talk, hype up how much they got, you know, $800 suits and shit. But anytime we ever see you in a suit, looks like it's falling off of you because it's not tailored. But you got 12 of them that are no less than $800. But you know we won't talk about that.
Borrow
that,
from your Uncle Johnny,
right? Or that house of cards and shit that you fucking that you claim to be. But anyway, fucking moving along. We got Jamarcus NOE in the building.
What you think about me?
Newberg in the building. What's happening, man?
What up, man? You're not represented for the city, though, but NOE, that's where I'm from. You know what it is.
Up here with this motherfucking black smoking us out.
We ain't going to promote them. They ain't gave me a check.
They ain't get no check?
Nah, ain't no check for Middleton's.
Man. Hey, you know what?
Whoever is at Middleton's, get at me. I want that check. I do all the commercials. They don't even do commercials.
Yeah, real shit, though. Like, I seen something you said earlier that's a great topic for our show.
What's up?
If somebody was going to take 300, if they was going to take 300 grand for the 360 deal, would they take it?
Would they take it? Are you asking me that? Or?
I'm asking just in general. Like,
I never gave my opinion on it. I saw some other people
on there talking about it. And it's, you know, my feelings on it. And I kind of stayed out of it because, you know, so I get vocal and then motherfuckers want to try to be smart and then I get mad. But, you know, my thing is anybody – in my opinion, even if you are getting pimped in a deal, 300K is a lot of money you could do something with. And damn near everybody gets pimped in their first deal.
Most people ain't never had 100K, KG. Yeah. You hear me? Yeah. So if I can take 300,000 and make it do what it do, come on, man.
Yeah, everybody gets pimped in their first deal.
I mean, you're going to get fucked on your first deal if your cousin ain't Drake or your brother ain't Lil Wayne or
you're not a 14-year-old white kid from fucking Ohio. you know what I'm saying?
Shit, exactly. So, I mean.
No crack ass cracker.
He's stupid.
He's fucked up.
Situation is awkward.
I'm good,
because he's
all
big and loud and his hair is so shiny.
He's still my nigga.
Hey, you know that's right. I love when I worked at Prime. And Jamarcus and Hurra's track, Fuck What You Think About Me, would pop off the club. Everybody goes nuts, man. So DJ Nitty shows these cats love around the city. I haven't been around over the Legends lately since Prime shut down. But, man, every time that song came on, every motherfucker in the place knew every word. Everybody stopped what they was doing. Groups of bitches was like, hey! You know what I'm saying? So shout out to Jamarcus for that.
Shout out Shit's to the hot. DJ. Shout out to Louisville. Shout out to the Kim
the
Kim
city,
DJ.
Yeah.
Shout out to KG.
DJ Slick, all them.
Yeah, shout out to all of them. But, the 300K, though, back on that. The 300K, who ain't going
to
take 300,000?
You got
like,
to.
If you living under, you know what I'm saying, the
and all
the every day.
It was over time, but they wouldn't take it as a motherfucking lie.
Raise your hand in this room right now if you would take 300,000. You goddamn right. I take a quarter million.
Yeah.
I take $100 right now. The fuck you mean?
Yeah. I mean, it's an opportunity. Just think, what if you put out the song that the people like and you recoup the money and everything goes as planned? Yep. Then you can renegotiate.
Yeah, that's
but
how
if
it is.
You
like
just
said,
say no, you might not ever get this chance again.
Never again. And
never
this shit
again.
Just
this shit don't come every day.
Especially the way the music game is now, man. It ain't, you know, ain't that many deals really like flying around. You know what I mean?
It ain't. You got to create your own buzz.
You
got to
create your own buzz and your own brand. You know, independent is the way to go a lot of times. But I mean, if a motherfucker's going to give you that kind of money and you can't do something and make somebody yourself
it's
with that kind
you.
Of money, it ain't for you.
It's
yeah,
ain't
it ain't for
you.
You.
It's just ain't for you anyway.
I'm going to put that shit on the street.
I'm going to make something happen with 50,000.
Exactly.
I'm
going to
make 50,000 look like a quarter million.
Exactly. All day.
I'm
hustlers,
all over
baby.
The internet.
Yeah,
I'm going to kill the internet.
Yeah. Oh, killing yeah. them.
I can
so what's,
shit.
So what's next for you, man? I mean, we all talking about killing the internet,
man.
What you got? What's coming
look,
up? Talk
I got,
to
I got some new singles I'm working on right now. Waiting on Slick to mix them down. They're going to be in the streets. But I'm moving more like in different markets. Like I'm trying. Like I don't really want to spend my promotion dollars in Louisville no more because I don't feel like I can do much in Louisville no more. I love my city. I'm always going to come back. I'm always going to stay down. But I got to push my – I got to get these show – it's show money. Ain't nobody came to me with $300,000 any money. So I got to build my buzz up so I can hit these little small towns and sad counties and different cities. And
I'm hitting
get
the road
35,
next month
I can go
the
get $3,500 a show. If I can get $3,500 a show three nights out of a weekend, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, or Friday, Saturday, Sunday, that's what? 7,000. What's that? 10-5? 10-5.
Yeah, 10-5.
If I can get 10-5 a weekend –
eating.
I can eat.
On your own, eating.
On my own, without a label or anybody. I got my own iTunes. I own all my own shit. You feel me? So,
I know. I done spent some money on her.
Appreciate it.
I done spent some
what's
money on her.
What's your iTunes information? How can they find you on iTunes?
You can hit me up on iTunes. Just search Jamarcus. The singles are still on there. I'm still pushing What You Think like it's brand new. I'm in other markets within them, though.
Yep.
Feel me? Louisville played it out. We still playing it. They still playing it. They rocking like it just came out. So to somebody live in Chicago or somebody live in New York City or somebody live in Baltimore, Atlanta, Alabama, it's brand new to them. So it's a brand
new. We got
to
call.
We got a call coming in. Caller, you on the line?
Scoony the Goon, DJ KG. What's up with y'all?
What's good? What's good? Turn your volume down in the background.
How's that?
Better. What's up with you?
What's up? What's today's topic?
Ain't you been listening, fool?
I'm saying you just gonna pick up the phone and just call and don't even know what's going on.
What's
today's topic? We got the homie Jamarcus in the building, man. You on the line with him right now?
What's up, Jamarcus? You pushing that new album, bro? Or what?
I am, man. I'm working on the new mixtape right now, man.
That's what's up. Doing them live shows, stacking that paper.
You know it.
That's what's up. Scoony the Goon, what you got going on, big boy?
Just over here hanging with my belly.
That's what's up.
Trying to find me.
Looking good, sounding good, man.
Trying to find me a couple grits, you know what I'm saying? The show's about to be over with. Shit.
Yeah, I wanted to call in and say what's up, man.
Appreciate you, man. The homie JB, big bro in the building.
It's JB, Jason.
JB,
hey,
what up, JB?
Give a little bit of instructions next time on how to download the app to the cell phone. My pops wants to check y'all tonight, man. He's a fan of y'all too, man.
That's what's up.
Shout out to Pat. Tell him thank you.
Look at it from the phone, though.
Is it hard?
He just didn't know how to get to it. I'll put the link up on the website.
No,
I appreciate that. I'll put the app link up for next week's show. I'll put it right underneath the player where they can click and hit the app.
Be tight. Hey, but it's mad love out here for y'all, man. Keep doing y'all thing. Just want to come in, call in and show some love one time.
Appreciate you, bro.
You. Good looks.
Peace.
Shout out to homie Big Bro Records, JB, calling in, fooling with us, man.
Yeah. Jibby Nunyo.
Yeah. Jibby Nunyo.
Yeah, that's what. Hey, I've been fucking with JB for a long time.
Yeah.
The game is what it is, man.
Hey, we don't do that, bro. We don't do that. We don't do that.
That's just that's what it's trying. Hey, look, just because I'm a big dude, don't be all like surprised and shit that I can take my voice that high. Doesn't mean shit. I still whoop your ass, Amiri.
We don't ever do that. That high pitch shit. We don't. We have monotone voices around here. We don't do that high pitch shit.
I'm gonna do this real quick.
KG, what you got coming up?
Man, I'm getting ready to hit the road. Me and the homie Mix Magic, man, we hit the road Thursday to Sunday, man, every weekend in October, man. It's going down. I got a show starting.
Where you at?
All over the Midwest, man. Starting up Wisconsin, coming through Indiana, down through Ohio. Got a show here in Louisville on the 9th. Waiting on Lexington, trying to get something going in Lexington. And then I got two contracts on two Tennessee shows on the table too that we're trying to hit.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Little Midwest kind of Southeast, you know, joint trying to get it
you
out
working,
there.
You working?
Yeah, man. Trying to, you know, my homie Mix Magic, man. We trying to get the new album, the mixtape's done, so we're gonna take it, hit the road, man.
You
push the mixtape.
You host the mixtape?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. It's gonna be dope, man. We got a lot of shit coming up, man. It's anybody tuning in and wants to check out, you know, check out the new music. It's mixmagic.net. Go check out the website. I'll kind of free downloads for you.
You got any shows coming up?
We was just talking about doing something in Radcliffe, but I'm kind of skeptical about going back to Radcliffe because last time I was in Radcliffe, somebody got killed at my show.
Oh, that's so, not good.
Yeah. I remember hearing about that. Was that the show that Hurt got shot at, wasn't it?
Yeah, I heard about that. Shout out to Hurt, man. He pulled through. That was good luck, but.
Yep. Shout out to Brooklyn and Hurt.
Yeah. But as long as the money right, though, I'm going to go back to Radcliffe. Shout out to Radcliffe, by the way, but I just got to be more.
Rocking with you, it got to be more safe.
Nah,
yeah.
Like it's crazy because you know normally I don't have security and shit. I don't.
No, nah, yeah, Collar, you cuss. We don't even let you.
Collar, you on the line with Jamarcus Noe and Goondocks. Holla. Hello. That's what I just did. That high pitch shit.
So yeah, it's all in the background. So I'm saying, yeah. Turn your background music down.
That's what he was wanting to do. He's trying to play that.
Oh, it's JB Collin playing that shit. JB's stupid.
Later.
Yeah, though, but Radcliffe. Radcliffe's like the next show we're supposed to have coming up. I'm trying to do anything outside of Louisville, man.
Just stop that call. Yeah, dumb.
Go ahead. I'm not going to answer.
Yeah, anything. You know. What's the number? I could just put it on my net. And then I can have
the number's 502-251-4440. Yeah, I've done a couple things down in Radcliffe, man. They got a nice little scene down there. There's some fun parties down there.
502-251-4440.
Caller, you on the line.
4440.
Oh, my God. Is this Goondocks?
Yes, it is.
Yo, this is Rucker.
What's up, Ruck? Homie?
Man, I'm calling y'all from the studio, just, you know, showing a little support.
Appreciate you, man.
And, you know, I kept getting those pop-up ads. I had, like, it made me watch 3 commercials.
I know, man. I'm working on it. I got a guy trying to build me a server right now, man. It's, you know, we're running through Ustream, man, and it's a pain in the ass.
I mean, if you want Rucker back as a viewer, you're going to have to get that fixed. No, I'm playing. Hey, no, I just wanted to show y'all some love. Shout out to y'all, Goondocks.
Appreciate that, man. Radio now in the building. My homie Ruck on the radio.
No doubt. We need to get back on there in the next few weeks, if possible, my man.
Yeah, man, just holler at me. You know, get some music together for me. That's the main focus.
Absolutely.
I got you. I know my man Jamarcus probably got some new radio tracks coming up, man. We had to bring him over and let him slide through on you.
Yeah, man. Just hit me up.
Yeah, I need your information.
I got you. Give me some more controversy, though. If I'm here, I got to be entertained.
You need some controversy. I'm good at making controversy. I know how to make it.
Oh, you did have a little bit of controversy going this past week or so, didn't you?
Touch that, yeah.
I mean, you know.
Ruck, we appreciate you calling in, homie. Keep doing what you do, man. That local music movement, man. Sunday night, y'all, 10 p.m. Check out my homie, 98.9, Ruck on the radio. But, yeah, I mean, can we touch on that? Or is that
We can talk about it.
I didn't really know what happened. I kind of saw the ass end of it. But was it something going on with you and some people over from the neighborhood or what was?
It wasn't really real beef, what I consider real beef. You know what I'm saying? It was like some shit. It was a misunderstanding, really. Like, It was a big misunderstanding. It was miscommunications, but it is what it is.
Shit happens. Really. I can dig it.
In this day and age, miscommunication happens a lot.
Yeah, so, I mean, but at the end of the day, I'm still rocking. I'm still doing what I'm doing. They doing what they doing. And we just put it behind us kind of like.
That's what's up. And it's good to see people do that, man, and let it come out on a positive note, you know what I mean, and not on no bullshit.
Taking this call.
Caller, you on the line with the Goondocks and Jamarcus. Who's this?
I was actually just wondering, my husband's trying to sell a snapping turtle. I was just wondering, do you all want to buy a snapping turtle?
Hey, man, I tried to buy that damn turtle last week, and he still ain't brought my fucking turtle over here. I knew it was you calling, too, baby. I knew that was you calling.
Yeah, but I'm trying to get rid of it.
I knew that was you, baby.
You
supposed to bring the turtle over here yourself, girl.
I got a snapping turtle in my pants.
I'm just letting you all know we have a great deal for it. $100 right now.
How about I give you $50 and you lick its ass?
How about I give you $25 and I stick my thumb in your ass?
Oh my God, you cannot put your thumb in my buttock.
All right, then we gotta go bad. Fuck your turtle.
I like turtles.
I still don't even know if I know who it was from last week. Somebody called trying to sell us a fucking snapping turtle. That's a great bit, though.
Shout out to Mike Drake over there clowning. I see you.
Oh, is that who it was? Yeah. Well, good. I'm going to stick my thumb in your old lady's butt and give her $25 and take your turtle. Fuck your turtle. Hey, man. Jamarcus, I appreciate you coming through and rocking with us, man.
Straight up, last minute, man.
You know, like I said, I just had tagged a couple people, man. You, her, Daddy-O.
You know, I gotta come back, man.
You gotta come back, man.
Bring some music next time.
Building the buzz, man. This is only our second show. You know, just trying to build it up, man. We got the nice new studio cracking, man. So, you know, we ready to hit the ground running with it. Nah, fuck that shit.
What's that right there?
It was nobody. Denied!
We cleared your ass.
Y'all rock with us next week, man. Scoony the Goon, goondocs.com, Jamarcus NOE. Shout out to Boombox Poets. KG.
Straight up.
Let's take one more call on the way out the door. We got one more call coming in here, y'all.
Picture right here of us up here from me.
Caller, you on the line with the Goondocks.
Jamarcus on the line.
Jamarcus is in the building.
What up?
What up, Jamarcus? It's your fans.
What? Who is this?
We fans.
What's good?
It's
a
Snotty, bro. How you doing?
Snotbox, what's good?
What's happening, bro?
I'm calling show a little support, man. I seen you, so you know. Show a little support, man.
You know it, man.
My people said, what's some more of that music dropping? We are deep. You don't speak a phone.
Man, I just told them, man, the music on the way, man. You know I've been dealing with the other markets, Snot, man. You know how it go, man. What you just say, it's time to take over the world.
Yeah,
Gotta take over the world, man.
Trying to take over the world. Plus, you know, Lando home, man. Shout out to Lando, man. They don't know who it is, man. Solid nigga right there.
That's what's up.
Yeah.
Jamarcus got the phone lines blowing up here, y'all. Look, we was getting ready to sign off, and now we got like 30 calls coming in.
What's up? Goondocks.com. You on the line with Jamarcus. Holla.
Hey, it's Kentucky Liberty Bell, and I just wanted to give a shout-out to y'all.
What's up, baby? How you doing?
I wasn't going to call, but I got the nerve to call.
Hey, I do appreciate that, though. It's one of my biggest supporters, my girl Liberty Bell, man. Y'all can hear her on the intro of my Second to None radio show, man. She's the female voice out here on there, man. Been rocking with me for years. I appreciate you calling in, baby.
All right.
Thank you for listening. Caller, you are on the line.
Hey, man. Somebody had done told me that I could call this number and buy a Snapper Turtle.
Yeah, you got
to buy the Snapper Turtle.
Go to www.thumbinaturtlebutt.com.
Hell yeah.
That's how you get your turtle. Jamarcus, I appreciate you coming in and rocking
straight
with us,
man.
7 to 8 p.m. every Tuesday right here from Second to None Radio Studios.
4 p.m. on the West Coast. Real quick, shout out to my sister, Jill. I love you out there on the West Coast in California showing love.
Our sponsor, Golf Oasis.
Golf Oasis.
Appreciate you.
Jason Kessinger, 1610 Dutch Lane, Jeffersonville, Indiana. Best golf simulators around this motherfucker. Y'all go check him out for real. Holla.
Request that music in them clubs, man.
Hit them up, man. Jamarcus Boombox. Make sure you're asking your DJs about him, man. Boombox Poets, Jamarcus. Check him out online. Jamarcus NOE. Goondocks, we out of here.
Peace.
Straight up.
So the internet radio show is called.